Hello students, welcome to the class of Editorial Decode, and in this class I will be decoding Breaking the Ice and Avoiding a Refreeze, written by Rakesh Sood. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in General Studies Mains Examination Paper 2. Plus this is very important for Political Science optional students. Plus this is also important from your essay point of view. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how the diplomacy is not working between India and Pakistan. This editorial is also about how we have not been able to carry forward the dialogue process. This editorial is also about how the Indian and the Pakistani dispensations, they have been getting more influenced from the extraneous factors, the factors of media, the factors of the civil societal pressures. Now, in order to properly understand this editorial, first of all, we need to understand about what does Pakistan stands for and what does India stands for. Now, as far as Pakistan is concerned, it is not a uniform country. Now, what is meant by it is not a uniform country? Uniform country means it is a country which is lacking in homogeneity. It is a country which is an embodiment of heterogeneity. Heterogeneity in terms of the power centers that are existing in Pakistan. In Pakistan, you will find terrorist stan. In Pakistan, you will find ISI stan. In Pakistan, you will find army stan. In Pakistan, you will find civil societal stan. In Pakistan, you will find fundamentalist stan. So there are n number of stans existing in Pakistan. And all these stans, cumulatively, they are not allowing the dialogue process to move between India and Pakistan. Now, why they are not allowing this dialogue process to move between India and Pakistan? The survivability of army and the survivability of ISI in Pakistan, it owes it to the sustainability of the dispute between India and Pakistan. Would the dispute get resolved, the legitimacy of the ISI and the army would be watered down. They will not be able to sustain themselves. Their financing, their legitimacy, their justifiability, and their ability to sit at the top of the hierarchy in Pakistan, it is all due to the dispute that is existing between India and Pakistan. Now, let us know something about India. Now, as far as India is concerned, it is Hindustan. It is not only Hindustan. There are two stans that are existing in India. One is BJP stan and the other is the Congress stan. But there are no substantive differences as far as both these political parties are concerned. There is no fundamentalism existing in India. There is no terrorist stan existing in India. We don't allow the army to have an upper hand in India. We don't allow the research and analysis wing to have an upper hand in India. So, if we look at the whole picture, if we look at the complete picture, the game is being played between two players on the Indian side and about 5 to 6 players on the Pakistani side. Now, this situation, it has remained since 1947. So, the equation has not much changed. The equation has actually got complicated. It is not getting resolved. It is not getting equated. So how can we resolve this situation? How this conundrum that is existing between India and Pakistan would be getting solved in the years to come. Now there are two situations, there are two perspectives we contemplate about what is going to happen in the future. Now as far as Pakistan as a country is concerned, it is getting fragile more and more day by day. Day by day the fragility of Pakistan is increasing. It has eroded its credentials, it has withered itself as a nation. The fundamentalism is at its peak in Pakistan. The Shia and the Sunni communities, they are not living in peace and harmony in Pakistan. They are really antagonistic to each other. And moreover, the involvement of the ISIS forces in Pakistan has further deteriorated the situation in Pakistan. So in the years to come, for about 20 years or for about 30 years, what we will see? We will see the breaking of Pakistan. The Pakistan, it will be broken into Shia country and into Sunni country in the years to come. In the years to come, there will be bifurcation of Pakistan. And this is something that is inevitable. This is something the army will not be able to stop. This is something that ISI will not be able to stop it. Now why they will not be able to stop it? Because they are fighting against the strong forces of ISIS. They are fighting against the strong forces of fundamentalism. Now in the years to come, so down the line when the Pakistan, it will be a broken country, then it will become feasible for India to resolve its dispute about Kashmir. Then it will become more easy for India to solve its problems. Now the situation is that India is acting like a solid and Pakistan is acting like a gaseous. India is acting like more tangible and Pakistan is acting like intangible. Because there is no unanimity about what they want to do and what and how the things should be moving, how the dialogue process should be conducted. Now as far as India is concerned, it is firm. Now as far as Pakistan is concerned, it is vociferous. They are breaking into its constituent parts. As far as India is concerned, we want the things to move by way of integration. This I have discussed in the previous class, how the dialogue process should be moving. This is something that has been said by Rakesh Sood in this editorial. According to him, if both the sides will engage in such a way that the situation will be a win-win situation for both the sides, only then we will be able to resolve the disputes. But if either of the side will be winning, it will be viewing the situation as a win and loss situation, in that case the dialogue process will not move forward. So the situation is really problematic, and the problematic situation can be solved if we act maturely. We also need to work on the way we are exercising, we are practicing and dealing in the diplomacy. We are acting in a more novice manner. We are allowing the media to exacerbate the things. We are allowing the media to heat up the things. We are allowing it to be baked at a melting point, which is actually not possible. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And you can also avail the information about the classes that we are offering on our websites, that is eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button and do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.